Hi, welcome to the Fancy Farm. They haven't seen me for a while. I thought I'd give you a little update on how it's going on the farm. Do a little tour, show you what I do. I got a few chores to do, and we'll take a look.
Here's Moses being all friendly. There's one of the rams. He was just jumping up. Oh, there he goes again. They like to eat the fresh snow off the roof. They have plenty of fresh water, but for some reason that interests them. Moses. He was just here being friendly. Let's see if I can get back. Let's go see Moses. Gretel. Hey, Belle. Belle's been really curious lately. What do you think, Hank? What do you think, huh? What do you think, hey? It's supposed to be pumping water. Water trough's overflowing. Use all my utensils for getting the ice off. What do you think, Otters? What do you think? First thing I'll show you is the frost-free is now tarped. It's got a bunch of layers of foam. We actually did freeze it because I left it exposed. So I had to replace it with the new one. Got it in. I just pumped water with the generator, so I got to get that put away. So we're still pumping water there, but instead of using a frost-free, we got an underground line that goes all the way into the pole barn home, which is nowhere near finished. And I see the house wraps falling down and everything else. Just been working too much and just trying to make ends meet and build at the same time. It's been tough and keep up on top of chores during the wintertime. So we got an underground line there. I'll show you that in a minute. First thing I want to show you is the solar system has been doing pretty well. We're pretty happy with it. Panels work fine on a nice day like this. It's about, you know, probably 3 o'clock in the afternoon. The sun's shining just enough down through the clouds that our solar system's doing good. So I'll show you the new addition. So since I don't get anything done around here, no, my father-in-law came and hooked up another 4 batteries for us and did it like a pro. I mean, look at that. Look at that. I'll try to find a picture of what it used to look like or a screenshot, and I'll try to show you my work versus his work. I mean, it's really tidy and nice. Let's see where we're at. So, right now, we've got all the lights on in the house. I got a hot water plumb now. We're sitting at 14 volts, full bars. The PV is still on. Photovoltaic is still on. But those batteries are just about fully charged. Now, while I was pumping water, my father-in-law also got us a battery charger. It's just a basic one. But it comes to this battery bank. And so while everything's running, it charges. And so instead of just wasting the whole generator, it's charging the batteries. I don't have a charge controller that has a generator hookup to be able to charge my batteries. So it's been nice to have his help and be able to make things halfway decent. So 14 volts during the middle of winter is actually a pretty good deal. Oh, 13. Oh, 14. 13.9. 13.8. Somebody's using some serious power inside. Anyhow, so that's doing good. Let's see what temperature is right now. This is for all you Canadian viewers. 3 degrees Celsius. That certainly is not right. I think that's as low as that thing goes. It's 11 degrees Fahrenheit, so I think it's a little colder than that. Obviously, that thing doesn't go any lower than that. So I'm gonna put a cover back on it. Don't want to leave it open, get too much snow in there, and we'll go check out the barn and the water line. Let's see how cold it is here. Hit the button again. That didn't work. Oh, gotta turn the key on. 8 degrees it seems to be. Really thankful for that plow. Traded a fellow, or he called me, said if you help me build a dog kennel in the spring, I'll trade you a plow. been thankful for that. Been able to keep the driveway open. We only have about a foot of snow, so it hasn't really been bad yet. But it'll pile up this winter, and we'll see where that goes. So, pretty thankful to have that. Just a beautiful day today. So, way back in the summer, you guys saw me digging with an excavator. And I was putting in the water line outside. This is where it comes up. Now, this is going to be into an interior bathroom wall on the barn when we have it. What you hear right now is a heater running, a propane heater that I turned on while I was pumping water because this is exposed to the cold. I don't want it to freeze. So I always warm it up with the heater. It's quite warm right now. And then we insulate it. So that trash can is lined with insulating foam on the inside, which Drea built. And then there's that blanket. So we wrap this, we take the hose off, wrap this in the blanket, set that trash can on top, and it has not frozen yet. And we got to -7 the other morning, and it hasn't frozen yet. So we'll see how that goes. So this is the inside of the pole barn. Just walls up and windows in, that's it. I still have to finish insulating the perimeter, put down plastic, a layer of vapor barrier, and then I'm building a raised floor in here in all my spare time. And so we probably won't be getting into it till the spring, but we're at least making progress. There's a door we're gonna use. There's all my scrap 2x4s. Drea has organized all these scrap 2x4s back here and 2x6s. So yeah, I got myself a royal mess. That's how I roll. Let's go for a little walk. So we kind of got a surprise to share with you. This contraption here, take it in. Okay, I'll explain in a few minutes what that's for. It's not an air conditioner unit. And yes, I know some of you are thinking, you want one that looks just like this. It looks so pro. Calm down. Calm down. Okay, for $99.99 plus labor and materials, you can have one just like this. I'll explain to you what that is in just a few minutes. The wood pile was all tarped, had a bunch of snow on it. I haven't been keeping the snow off, and we couldn't even get into the firewood. So I decided to pull the tarp off, and in the process of doing, I tipped the whole wood pile over backwards and made a big mess. I also have some wood right here that still needs to be split that I haven't put in the wood pile. I know, behind on everything. So my task, before the sun gets down, when I'm finished talking to you guys, that is to restack all this wood in a nice organized manner. Also, this is the hose that I left out when I was just pumping water for the animals a few minutes ago. So first task is I gotta coil that whole hose up and put it away. Now, I know I said I was gonna go roll up that hose, but I thought I better take a minute and show you just a work of, look at that. Everybody likes a good chainsaw. Look at that. Look at her lines. So, this is the inside of that little whale house shed that we had here. I finally got the roof on. And the reason you've never seen the inside before, gas cans are just out because I had a heater going, folks. Come on. Don't worry about that mess, okay? But the reason you've never seen the inside is because it was completely unacceptable for somebody to see. And you know, if it's unacceptable for me to show you, it's pretty bad. But it's getting there now, a little tidier. But what I wanted to show you is the hook in the ceiling and how we hang our hose up when we're done. Now what I do is I hang it from the ceiling. And then this is our kerosene heater, which we had used in our home before. I run that and I turn that on. About 2 hours later, this hose is pretty much completely thawed out, and then I can pump water. So if I know I'm going to pump, I come out here, turn the heater on, let it thaw out, do other tasks in the meantime, and then do that. So probably, I'm guessing probably close to 3 o'clock. So I better get going. I got quite a bit of wood to split and restack. So here I go. I better get busy into that. Bramble, what are you thinking? Now, some of you have probably noticed that my wood pile's a little small. I know I need more wood, but for some reason, my father-in-law hasn't cut me any yet. So, I mean, every other time I procrastinate, he seems to come to my rescue. So, maybe it'll work out this time. All right, so I got the rest of that wood all bucked up and split.
moved around. I gave the kids a few lessons on stacking, and they're going to be stacking that up tomorrow. I just wanted to show you how responsible I was that I put all the fuel. Oh. Great. What are you excited about?
Okay, so what that contraption is a hot water tank. Or a hot water...
A tankless hot water heater.
Yeah. And we have gone
So for... you've gone like a total of, what, 2-3 weeks without hot water?
Yeah, we've gone over 8 months.
Oh, without, 8 months. I was a little off.
Without hot water. So that's a long time. And,
yeah.
Joel just hooked it up today. We now have hot water. When I turn on my sink, we have hot water coming out of there. And we are going to take our very first shower in here.
For the last 8 months. Yeah, we've had a shower in the last 8 months.
At other people's houses.
This is the first one we're going to have in our trailer.
We've boiled water for everything. For dishes, everything. For cleaning, for...
For 8 months, Drea's been standing here washing dishes every day by boiling 2 kettles of water.
And so you don't have anything instant. It takes time.
I'm a terrible husband. But
no, it's cold.
We bought the tankless hot water heater. Now, I made some mistakes. At the beginning of the summer, I was kind of thinking in a different direction. I bought an exterior hot water heater. My idea was is that it would last longer and be a little more durable. Well, I wasn't thinking about the exhaust port. The interior ones have like a 4-inch exhaust port that you can just duct out with a piece of ducting. The exterior didn't. It had a big duct on the front. When we bought it, we kept it in the box because we didn't want to get scratched up until we figured out how to hook it up. When I took it out, I was like, oh no! There's this big vent on the front. What am I going to do? So that was the solution you saw outside. So the tank is leaning on its side, slid in. And I'll show you that in a minute. But
it's kind of cool, too, because you can get it low enough on the temperature gauge that we only have one line hooked up to the sink. It's the hot water line. And we can knock it down to where I find like 108 is a really good temperature. And we just keep it on that. And so we don't even need to use two lines, which is kind of nice because I think it helps conserve water a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, mixing maybe it. That's try to get the temperature down by adding
right.
cold water. If it's set too high, you use more cold water and you end up kind of using more volume.
Yeah.
Only so much can go through the pipe. But...
Also, we have freezing problems because this is our really cold spot in the trailer. Mm-hmm. And so our water line kept freezing up. But now we have warm water going through hot water.
Yeah.
So we probably won't have... that struggle as much.
We're hoping not to. And should we want just straight cold water, like for our, we got an Alexa water
or
purifier here that we drink.
Dogs.
We want just pure water. It's just a quick click of a button. We can actually turn the water off. So I'll show you how that works. If you look over here, this is a remote control that came with it. The water temperature is set to 108 degrees right now. And it's as simple as I can just click the up button. Adjust the temperature, 120. It goes quite hot. Or I can just... Oh, I keep hitting the power button. I can turn it down. Just hold it, turn it down to wherever we would like to. It has a power button here, so it's quickly. We can just shut it off. If we want just cold water, it won't turn on. The water cycles through it. And it can turn on. Now, in the bathtub, it has cold and hot water pumps so that we can have a shower and it can mix and get to a good temperature. So, sometimes if you have a bath, you like to add just straight hot water to bring the whole temperature of the tub up. So, that'll be nice. So, that just sits there. I'll permanently mount that. If you look over here, this is the tankless water heater. So, it's a Camp Lux 20-liter residential outdoor water heater. I had to lay it down. So I built this box that you saw from outside. It's insulated with 2-inch foam all the way around. There's an air gap here. It sucks in the air. Heated air from in here goes into there. All the fixtures are in the inside right here. So nothing should freeze or expose here. I used all red piping because it blends with the colors in here with the red rather than like a bright blue or bright white. The red actually kind of hides better. And Andrea... And I'm probably not going to get it quite as nice, but it's all covered with a curtain, so it's not an eyesore to look at. So, we showed you the exciting news.
Yeah, we're becoming civilized around here.
A little bit civilized. The budget on the barn has been tight, so we're going to end up having a winter inside this fifth wheel, which is not ideal and not desirable. That's part of the reason we held off on the hot water tank is we're planning on putting it in the barn. But things haven't quite worked out that way, but we will get in there. So we're going to have to winter in here, which will be tough, but we're making the best of it. Drew's got this place pretty organized, and it fine-tunes every day.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to drink a little bit of tea, and we're going to go try out our nice hot water.
Have a shower.
Have a shower. Our first one in 8 months. Well, in this house, but.
Oh, that's another thing. We also upgraded our water tank. It was that smaller tank.
Yeah.
Now we're double that amount.
We have a 55-gallon drum. Well, thanks for watching our video. Wanted to touch base and let you guys know I was still alive.
Yep.
And
he still lives here.
Yeah. And appreciating all the hard work Drew's been doing around here. She really made this, all these pens and stuff come together. It's been... Well, all right. Well, thanks for watching, and we'll talk to you later.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.